Hello, I'm Liesel Ehlers. I'll be presenting a lesson on mathematics level 4. And for today's lesson, we'll focus on differentiation, specifically differentiation rules. And then towards the end of the lesson, we are going to use this differentiation rules to determine the equation of tangents. So let's get started. We know that for a curved graph, the gradient at every point is different. So mathematicians wanted to develop a method to determine the gradient at a specific point. So they used what they knew about the formula for gradient between two points and also limits, and they developed the following method, the following formula. So when I use this formula, I will actually be determining the gradient at a certain point. And we'll refer, if the graph we are using is f, then we'll refer to this gradient as f prime x, or we can say it's the derivative. Now, you've been using this formula and you got a certain answer. Now, if you take a certain f, you'll see that there's a definite pattern between what you start off with and the answers. And this led them to determine or to produce some rules. Differentiation rules, and we will be looking at these differentiation rules. The differentiation rules that you must be able to use in mathematics level 4 are the following. If I've got an x to the power n, then the differentiation rule says the derivative will be n x to the power n to the power n minus 1. You must be able to do the derivative, use this one where we differentiate a constant. You must be able to differentiate ln kx, e to the power kx, and then also sine x, cos x, and tan x. But we will look at each one individually as we are doing examples. The first example, determine the derivative of the following with respect to x. It's important to see that they also instruct me here to give the final answers with positive exponents and also insert form. So, if I look at this first example, and I want to differentiate. Let's say I want to differentiate, so I say the derivative is, I will run into a problem, because I see the first one here, that first term to differentiate is this one here, but this x to the power 2 is in the denominator, and the rule that I have says I must have an x to the power n in the numerator. So I'll have to change this first. We have done previously the exponent rules that says, but if I have an x to the power n in the denominator and I want to take this power upwards, then the sign of this exponent will change to negative n. The sign will change. So if I cannot differentiate directly, let's wipe out this, because I have to get the format ready first. So if I get the format ready, I'm going to rewrite the y in such a form that I'm going to actually apply the rules. It will be negative 2x to the power, negative 2, because I took the x to the power 2 to the top in the numerator position. Then also I have another rule that will help me, an exponent rule that you've done previously, that will help me to actually to write this third form into exponent form. And this rule says, if I have a third form, I can write the base and then the inside exponent will get the top position of the fraction and the outside value here will get the bottom position. So let's use that. So I know there's actually an x to the power 1 inside, and we all know there's actually a little 2 outside. So I can write this as x to the power half. Here the x is actually on top. It is in the numerator position, so no problem. And there I've got a constant 5. So I'm ready to differentiate. So if I differentiate this, and I use this first rule, it says I have to take the exponent to the front, then I'll have an x to the power 1 less than what I had previously. So it's going to be the negative 2 must be multiplied with the negative 2, which is already in front. It will give me 4. Then x to the power, what I had is negative 2 minus a 1. In the next one, I would say I take the negative half to the front, If I take the half to the front and multiply with what I already have, it's going to be minus 2 x to the power negative a half, because a half minus the 1 is negative a half. Plus, let's apply the rule again. I take the exponent to the front, it's a 1 over 5 x to the power what I had minus 1, which will be 0. And then I'm going to use this other rule, this rule that says, but the derivative of a constant is zero. I'm going to use it with this last term. So in this last term, the derivative of the constant will be zero. And now I'm just ready to simplify this. I've got 4x to the power negative 3 minus 2x to the power negative a half plus a fifth, because the x to the power 0 is equal to 1, and then I don't have to write the 0. But do you remember they specifically said they must give my answer with positive exponents? So if I change, and I'm going to use this rule again, my exponent rule, that says the moment you shift the position of the power from top to bottom or bottom to top, the sign of the exponent will change. So this negative 3 will change to positive 3. So in this case as well, I'll shift it to the denominator position and I have the fifth. But I'm not done yet, because whenever the fraction is in exponent form, it can be written in third form. I'm going to use this, but I'm just going to reuse it backwards. So I'm using that rule, exponent law, that says I can write it in third form. Then the top part, the 1 will go inside and the 2 will go outside, which I don't have to write. And there I've got my final answer. Let's move to a next example. The next example, and let's decide now to actually, in all of these examples, give the final answer with positive exponents and in third form. So the next one, I see I have to differentiate e to the power 5x. And I see I've got a rule that says if I have e to the power kx, the derivative will be k e to the power kx. So I just apply the rule and say in this case, the k will be 5. So it will be 5 e to the power 5x. In the next example, I have to differentiate. Again, I see that what I have, the first term is e to the power 3x, next term e to the power x, and then I've got a third term. So in the first one, I write down the half, and now I'm going to use my rule to actually differentiate e to the power 3x by using this rule that I have on my formula sheet. So it's going to be k, and in this case, it's e to the power 3x. The 3 is replacing the k, so it's 3 e to the power 3x, which is actually on top of 1. I've got the minus 2 as a constant, which will stay, and I have to multiply it with what follows. Now, let's use my rule again. It's the k, in this case, is negative 1, e to the power negative x. And now I've got this last term, so I have to be careful not to say, oh, the exponent is 1, so remember, it's not e to the power x. So I cannot use this rule number 4 as it is given there. Let's see, what is this? What is this 4e? And for this, I'm going to pick up my calculator and try and figure out what is 4e. So I want you to look on your calculator, this button there where it says LIN. The LIN button, just above the LIN button, it actually says e to the power something. So to get to that, I'll have to press the shift button together with then after that the LIN button. It will actually ask me e to the power what. So I'll punch in 4 and then also e. I'll punch in 4, shift that button to the power 1, and I'll get this 4 e to the power 1 is actually 10.873, and there's more values after the comma. 10.873. Remember, so what I actually know is that this 4e is 10.87 and more values. It's a constant. And I've got a rule that says the derivative of a constant is zero. So I know the derivative will be actually 0. Now I just have to simplify what I have here. It's simplified. It's on top I've got 3 e to the power 3x divided by 2. Negative and negative is positive. 2, I've got e to the power negative x, but remember they don't want the negative exponent. So I use that rule that says the moment I shift the base e downwards with its exponent, the exponent will become positive, and I don't have to write the plus 0. Number four says I have to differentiate this, and I'm gonna use the rule number 3 on the list. Rule number 3, as it's indicated here, ln kx will be k over kx. So if I differentiate this, I just use the formula as it is given to me. I have the 5 as a constant. Then for the ln 6x, remember the rule said the answer of differentiation will be k over kx. So in this case, the k is 6 over 6x. The 5 is over 1. And I know the 6 will cancel with the 6. Therefore, my final answer is 5 over x. Let's look at a few more examples. In this case here, I have to differentiate sine and cos and tan. But I want you to see that on the formula sheet, they actually gave me the derivative of sine x, cos x, and tan x. They didn't give me how to deal with kx. That I'll have to know myself. So what I usually do is I take this k, this e to the power kx, to guide me, because I saw the derivative is k times the e to the power kx. So just the same way, I will remember that for sine kx, I have to multiply the derivative. The derivative will have a k in front. Okay, so let's do the first example. The derivative of sine x, well, straightforward, I just use my formula sheet, is equal to cos x. But the derivative of sine 5x will be, remember what we said, I have to remember the k value first, so it's 5. Then I go to the formula sheet and I say, but sine's derivative is cos, so it will be cos 5x. In the next example, number 7, the derivative will be, in this case, I've got a constant 3, so I write down the constant 3 first. Then if I differentiate the tan 2x, remember the derivative of tan I see is 6 squared, but it's 2x. So I'll have to remember to multiply with a k, which is 2 in this case. And then what is the derivative of tan? It's 6 squared. And if you started with a 2x, you will end up having an angle 2x. Let's simplify that. 3 times 2 is 6. 6 squared, 2x. I can actually summarize these rules of sine kx and tan x for myself. Let's just summarize this. If they just told me that the derivative of cos is negative sine, as I can see there, then I will remember for the derivative, I have to multiply with a k. We know the derivative of cos is negative sine, and then remember if you start with a kx, you'll end up with a kx. For this third one, y is equal to tan kx. The derivative here of tan is 6 squared, but I have to remember the k first, then I remember it will be 6 squared of kx. We are at example number 8. For example number 8, I have a few terms. I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 terms to differentiate. Let's start with the first one. So this is a mixed problem. I have to look at all the possible rules to guide me. Can I differentiate straight away? Well, let's see. I cannot, because this x is in the numerator and the rule says it's in the denominator and it must be in the numerator to be able to use this first rule. Even this second last term, it's not in exponent form, it is in cert form. So I'll have to change this to exponent form first. So I cannot start off saying the derivative is. I still first have to write down this y as it is, but in the correct form. So I've got the 2 ln x. I'll have a rule to help me to differentiate that one. For the next one, I have to take this x to the power 3 over 2 to the numerator position. So the exponent will change to negative. Then I've got a ln 3 that I'll have to see what to do with just now. And now this one I have to write in exponent form. Be careful. Both terms, both values, the 3 as well as the x cubed, are actually below the square root sign. So I have a square root 3, which I can leave in insert form. And then I've got a x, which I have to write in exponent form. The base x, remember there's actually a little 2 outside, so it's going to be to the power 3 over 2, and then I've got a plus 8. Let's differentiate now. So, the derivative of this first term. The first term, I'm going to use rule number 3, which says the derivative of ln kx is k over kx. So remember the 2 in front is a constant. What is the k in this case? It's 1. Ln kx, ln 1x. So the derivative will be 1 over 1x. For the second term, I'm using this first, the first rule on my list, which means I write down the constant that I have. Then it's going to be, let's say that constant must be multiplied with a negative 3 over 2 because I'm going to take the negative 3 over 2 to the front. And then I'll end up having an x to the power 1 less than what I originally had. So it's going to be negative 3 over 2 minus 1 will give me negative 5 over 2. Plus, and now I have to differentiate the ln 3. So what is ln 3? It is not... it's not this rule. It's not ln x. It's ln of a constant. But is ln 3 a constant? What is ln 3? Let's check on our calculators. If I take my calculator and I actually use this button, the ln button, I can actually say what is ln 3? Ln 3 is 1,0986, etc. So, and more places after the, it's a constant. So, since I know it's a constant, I can go back there and say, but I know the derivative of a constant is 0. And then, let's do the second last term. I've got the constant square root 3, which must be multiplied with this exponent that I'm going to take to the front. So, if I take the exponent to the front, let's just move my set of rules a little bit away, then it will be, I have to multiply it with 3 over 2, x to the power, whatever I had, and that is 3 over 2, minus 1, 1 and a half minus 1 is a half, and then what's the derivative of the 8? It's 0, which I don't have to write. Let's simplify what I have here. So it's going to be 2 over x, if I multiply this. The next term, for the next term, negative times a negative is positive. So it's going to be positive. But I see I can actually cancel this 2 with this 2. So I will have positive 3. I don't want the x with a negative exponent in my final answer. So I'm going to shift it to the bottom position in the new denominator position. It's going to be positive 5 over 2 plus 3 square root 3s. Over 2, and then I've got x to the power half. So the final thing I have to do now is I just have to change all the fractions, the powers which with fractions into cert form, which will give me 2 over x plus 3. This can be written in cert form. It will be x to the power 5 because the top part of the fraction always gets the inside position, and then there's a little 2 outside here which we don't have to write, plus 3 square root 3s over 2, and on top I have a square root x. these rules that we've just done, we're going to use them to actually determine the equation of a tangent and maybe answer other questions on tangents. In the first example that I have here, they say, given a curve, y is equal to 4x minus x squared, which we know is actually a parabola. If we draw a rough sketch of that, I know at least it's going to be a parabola and it will have this shape. The reason why I say it will have this shape is because there's a negative in front of the x squared. So we remember that sad face, it will have this shape. So the question is, determine now, using differentiation, the gradient of the tangent at the point x is equal to 2. Now, I don't know where that tangent is. What is a tangent? A tangent is just a straight line that's going to touch this curve at one single place. So I have to determine the gradient, the slope of that line, the tangent. But what we know from what we have just said previously, we know the gradient will be equal to the derivative. At any point on this curve, the gradient will be described by the derivative. Now, let's differentiate what we have. If we differentiate this first term, 1 times 4 is 4, x to the power 0, 1 less. In the next term, I take the 2 to the front, so it's going to be minus 2x to the power, 1 less. So I'll have 4x to the power 0, which is 1, minus 2x. In other words, the gradient replace the x value with a 2, and it will give me 4 minus 4, which is actually equal to 0. So, just for the sake of interest, and it's actually going to help you in the future lessons, where is this point where x is equal to 2? This point where x is equal to 2 must be exactly there at the turning point. Why? Because I found in this calculation that the gradient is 0. And the only place where the gradient is actually exactly 0 is there at the turning point. At the turning point, the gradient will be 0. On this side, the gradient will be something positive, and then it will change to exactly 0 before it goes negative on the other side. So, and we are also going to use this fact that the gradient is 0 at the turning points when we are doing cubic graphs. If we look at the next example, they say find the equation of the tangent, to this graph. F of x is negative x squared plus 3x minus 6 at the point where x is equal to 3. So the equation of a tangent is the equation of a straight line, because a tangent is just a straight line touching the curve at a certain point. So what I have in this case is again a parabola, and I have a straight line touching at a certain point. I'm not very sure where that point is, because I will still see. So I have to determine the equation of this line. Now, a straight line has got the basic formula, y is equal to mx plus c. So I need to determine the gradient as well as the c value, which is the y-intercept. Let's start with the gradient. The gradient will be the derivative. And the derivative of this f is f prime x. Let's differentiate it. If I differentiate the first term, I'll take the 2 to the front and multiply with that negative that I have already there. So it's negative 2x to the power 1. Plus, if I differentiate the next term, it's going to be 1 times 3 is 3x to the power 0, which is 1. And the last term will give me a derivative. The derivative will be 0. So I want to know, what is this gradient at the point where x is equal to 3? So let's replace the x with a 3, and also on the other side I have to replace the x with a 3. So I'll get negative 2 times 3 plus 3 is negative 6 plus 3, which is negative 3. So the gradient at that point where x is equal to 3 is negative 3. Okay, which tells me, yes, probably this is about right because the gradient I can see is negative. Okay, but at this stage I can say the gradient is negative 3x, the gradient is negative 3, so now the only outstanding value to calculate is the c value. How will I do this? I have something to substitute, a point x which is on this curve, which will then also be on the tangent, and I can substitute this into the tangent, but I don't have the y value. So they didn't give me the y value to which goes with it, and I need actually the x value as well as the y value to substitute so that the only unknown to be calculated is the c. So how will I calculate this y value? Well, I know this point is lying on both the tangent as well as on the curve, so I can actually replace the x with a 3 because I have the equation of the parabola. So let's replace every x with a 3. It's 3 times 3 minus 6, so it's negative 9 plus 9 minus the 6, which will give me negative 6. Okay, now I know this is negative 6, the y value that goes with the x value. Let's continue now. If I substitute this in the place of the y, I'll put the negative 6, will be equal to negative 3 times the x value plus the c. So the c will be negative 6. Negative 9 goes over, it becomes positive 9, so c is equal to 3. So let's finalize. The final answer would be then, y is the gradient we already determined to be negative 3 plus the c value, which is 3. And there's the equation of the tangent. And with that, the end of the lesson. Okay, what we have done in today's lesson is we have looked at the rules of differentiation and then we actually applied it using it to determine the equation of a tangent. Now, in our next lesson, we'll do the second application of differentiation, which is rates of change. In our third lesson, we will do another application of differentiation, which is cubic graphs.